Hello, okay friends, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching my video, my channel is all about orchids. From what orchids I have, how I grow them, my thoughts on certain orchid topics, to what orchids in my collection are blooming, etc. So if you want to follow along my orchid hobby adventure, please consider subscribing to my channel and turn on the notification. Today in this video, we're going to take a look at my Phalaenopsis Sweet Memory M. I have two Sweet Memory M's, and this is a habit of mine. If there is a hard to find orchid that I can get a hold of, and if I can afford it, I get two, just in case one of them is having problem. And here is a video of both of them flowering and the documentation of it. I hope you enjoy it. We will start with my Sweet Memory M number one. Around fall 2018, late fall 2018, it started to put out a new spike from the base. And last year, it already had one spike, which also elongated with two buds. So I was obviously very excited. And pretty soon, around beginning of 2019, January, it started to open its first bud. And obviously, I went picture crazy. I took a bunch of photos to document how this orchid opened its flower and how the flower looked and progressed as time goes on. Because when this orchid first opened its bud, the color looks a lot more intense. It's more on the red side. And then as time goes by, the color will fade into a really cute pink color. And the new spike was also producing two buds at the time, so I knew this orchid would put out a mini show for me, because last year it had one spike and it only gave me one flower. And I believe that was the very first flower that this orchid has ever had, because I bought this orchid as a mature size plant and it did come with that first flower spike, but I didn't see any sign of previous bloom. I just saw this spike, you know, coming out straight. But so last year, I think that the bloom was its first bloom. And this year, the flower spike continued to elongate, so I was very, very happy about it. And as usual, just like last year, this orchid is super fragrant. In the morning, the fragrance is really strong. And, you know, if I put my nose close to it, it's so strong that I need to, you know, step aside a little bit, because it is really perfumey. But I really enjoy it. And for those of you who just happen to stumble upon my video, Phalaenopsis Sweet Memory Leodoro is a very specific cultivar. That's what it's called, Leodoro. And this one is Sweet Memory M. They all share the same parentage, which is Violacea and Deventeriana. But M has its own set of characteristics that are slightly different from Leodoro. And if you go online and look up the differences, there are many people sharing their experiences. And I will make another video to share with you the two type of orchids and how they differ and how they share similarity. Because I also have two Leodoros in my collection. And here is a quick video clip just to give you additional insight on how this orchid was doing at the time and how it was looking. And here you can see that the second bud on the first flower spike was hiding behind the bloom, and it was, you know, growing as we speak. It was really, really nice to have this orchid bloom in the early, well, late winter in my area, because I was dying for some flowers, some sign of spring, and this orchid gave me that, so it was really, really nice. So this orchid is potted in semi-hydro method, and you can see here there is no water in the reservoir because I was still waiting for the bottom part, the reservoir part, to get even drier. Because if you look at the mix section or at the top layer of the media, you see how those pebbles is much lighter in color, and I actually want the middle portion and the bottom portion to look like that before I would even consider adding water. So that's just how I like to provide the really wet, you know, the really wet and really dry cycle, the wet-dry cycle. And a lot of these roots really enjoy that wet-dry cycle. And you can see here, I mean, some of the new roots are already growing into the reservoir. So when I add water to the level of the drainage hole, that's, to me, that's what I call the autopilot mode, because this orchid is accustomed to the high moisture, high humidity condition, and yet also, you know, is accustomed to the wet dry cycle that I provided. So far it's working pretty well, so hopefully this is the trend that will continue. And here we have my second one, my M number 2. So this one also shoot out a spike toward beginning of 2019, and then it continued to grow really really fast. And it also kept its original flower spike from last year, which was really good because it was also elongating. But I think it only gave me one flower on that old spike, which is fine because its new spike, I could tell it was growing at least 2 buds. So this orchid at least would give me 3 flowers this year, which is much better than last year's 1 flower. So I'll take any additional flowers I can get out of these orchids. If you're interested in getting an orchid like this, I have to warn you, you may have to be prepared to spend at least $50 for a mature size, flowering size sweet memory. I pay $50 for both of my sweet memory M's, and I pay a little bit more than $50. I'm not going to tell you exactly how much for my Leodoros. So they're more on the expensive side, and it's just something that's not as common to, you know, it's not as easy to find them in the US, and that's why, the rule of economics, right? Supply and demand. When there is not enough supply, it tends to get a little bit more expensive. So just be prepared to pay slightly more for an orchid like this. And here is a close-up of the am flower, just to give you a sense of what it looks like up close. And coming up, we're going to see the side-by-side pictures of my number 1 and my number 2s at the time. They all look pretty similar, except that number 1's flower is slightly lighter in color because that flower was much older than the flower that you see from the number 2, which is on the left-hand side. And how I differentiate them is, you know, number 1 has only 1 clip, and number 2 has 2 clips. That's how I differentiate, because I thought about writing numbers on the cup, but then I'm like, you know what? No, I don't really want to see numbers on the cup. Something that maybe something I can erase after they're out of bloom, or maybe I should put labels at the bottom of the cup. But the clips is what I'm using this year to differentiate my number 1 and number 2. And here we have a clip, video clip footage of my number 1 and number 2 being side by side on a different side of my growing rack. They just look beautiful, and they were really fragrant. When I was taking this video footage, I was smelling the fragrance, and it was just very nice. So yeah, if you can get a hold of one, I strongly recommend it. It's a really rewarding orchid to grow. And you know, you might want to even try out semi-hydro, because they do really well in semi-hydro in my environment. And I think that they're easy orchid to grow. And if you have one and get them to bloom, I believe that you'll like their flowers, the way they look, as well as their fragrance just as much as I do. I really think they're great, great orchids to have in anybody's collection. This is all I have for you today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to get more orchid-related videos from my channel, please subscribe and turn on the notification. I want to wish you happy growing, and I will talk to you in my next video. Ciao!